Today, we find ourselves back in Paris, and we slow down the pace as we board a boat on the River Seine. Ducas-sur-Seine has the Alain Ducasse imprint on it. From the concept to the interiors, down to the little details, you know exactly why Alain Ducasse has 20 Michelin stars.
Francis Fauvel is the captain of this kitchen. They are open 7 days a week with a staff of 25 that keeps the restaurant running like a well-oiled machine. No small feat in a compact, not to mention moving, kitchen. Below deck, we get a sneak peek of what we're having for lunch today.
They added a bit of hazelnut butter to this dish just to really highlight the seasonal aspect of their cooking, which is something that Alain Ducasse really does. Wonderful. How beautiful is this?
Madame Monsieur, here we have the blue lobster coming with some salsify and chestnut.
Beautiful. I mean, the colors here are just absolutely just perfect for the season.
Look at that plating. We have some blue lobster from Brittany, some salsify, a winter vegetable that resembles a parsnip, but tastes like oysters, and a creamy chestnut puree.
It's art on a plate.
All right.
Bon appétit.
Bon appétit.
Beautiful.
I'm always so worried when I try to cook lobster. I always overcook
you
it.
You cook lobster?
Yeah, every now and then, you know,
we
try to do it at home. Trust me, it's not as fancy as it sounds when it's...
Can you invite me over?
Yeah, absolutely. When are you in New York? Food is just straight up delicious. And you can't say anything more about that, because when the food is great, the service is excellent, and the wine is there, That's really all you need.
And you're surrounded by Paris.
Yeah, I know.
And, you know, on beautiful Seine, how much better can it get?
Cheers.
Dessert is a Paris chocolate delight, perfectly paired with a 1998 Chateau Cigala Rabot.
When you do this, when you know, and when it has the tears here,
yeah,
that's what shows you that it's a dessert wine.
It shows you a bit more viscosity. Yeah.
Correct. You know, I did pick up a wine fast when I was in
Sciences Po. Awesome. Yeah, I love that.
Yeah, I took it up and enjoyed the tastings.
I know. I feel like you just find something that you love to drink, and then you just, you know, you branch out from there, and that's really how you start learning about wine.